Have you ever thought to yourself, I wish I could instantly test my strategy without waiting months or even years, just to see if my trading strategy is even good or not? Well, what if I told you there's a way to test any trading strategy you want on years of data from the past, instantly, to see right then and there if your trading strategy is profitable or not? Instead of just believing a YouTuber that says they have a 100% win rate strategy, why not test it yourself to see if it really is that good or not, and see how it compares to your strategy that you're currently using. In this video, I'm going to show you exactly how to do that by backtesting your strategy on TradingView with past years of data, so you can see just how successful your trading strategy really is. First things first, we need to go to TradingView. I'll leave a link in the description. And as a side note, this is completely free to use and you don't need a paid subscription or anything, which is pretty awesome. Once you're on TradingView, go to the chart option on the top here. Then type in any security you want to test your strategy on. This will work with anything, stocks, forex, crypto, whatever. For this example, I'm going to test the Vanguard S&P 500. Now, for this video, we're going to test a very simple trading strategy, just so you guys can kind of get a grasp on the basics of backtesting. If this video gets a good response and you guys really want to see more of this, I'll do a second video where I'll get a little bit more advanced. The trading strategy example we'll do is just a simple moving average strategy. It's pretty simple. We'll have a 20-day moving average and a 50-day moving average. We want to buy when the 50-day crosses below the 20-day, and we want to sell when the 50-day crosses above the 20-day. Like I said, very basic and simple, but this is just to show you the basics of backtesting. I should also mention that TradingView has a page where it has a bunch of pre-built-in variable functions, so you don't have to custom make all of them. We're going to be using a lot of them in this video, so I'll leave that in the description as well if you want to go check that out. So once you type in whatever security you want to test, you're going to go down and click on this bottom tab that says Pine Editor. The very first line is what we want to name our trading strategy. So we're going to name this Simple Moving Average Strategy. Next, we're going to set our variables. The first one we'll call EMA 20 for our 20-day moving average, and the second one we'll call EMA 50 for a 50-day moving average. Next, we're going to use the built-in EMA function from the TradingView page I was talking about before. So we just type in EMA parentheses. Now, this function takes two parameters. The first parameter is if you want the EMA to read from the open or close of a candle as a reference point. With moving averages, it's probably best you read from the close, so we'll do that for this strategy. Then the second value is the time frame. So for a 20 moving average, we're going to set it to 20. Then you're going to do the exact same thing for this one, but make it 50. So this part of the code is defining basically what we call a 20 EMA and a 50 EMA. So instead of typing all this code over, we can just type in 20 EMA or 50 EMA. Next, we're going to set our long and short conditions. So we want to go long if EMA 20 is above the EMA 50. Then we want to go short if the EMA 20 is below the EMA 50. So keep in mind, these aren't entry points, but they are just simply telling the bot what we define as a long and what we define as a short. To do entry points, we're going to use another built-in function, which is strategy.entry. The first parameter is the name, so we call this entry long, and then the second parameter is what we actually want it to do, so type in strategy.long. The third parameter is how many shares you want to purchase, so in this example we'll just do 1,000 shares. Then the fourth parameter is when we actually want to execute the trade, so we type in win equals long, which is saying we want to execute a long trade when these parameters above are met. So as an overview, we have the name, whether we want to go long or short, the amount of shares, and when we want to execute. Then we're going to do the same exact thing for a short trade. So name this short, strategy we want is short, still have it as 1,000 shares, then we want it to execute it when the short condition is true. Right now we have it set up to where it's longing and shorting, but it's not actually closing positions at this time, it's just constantly opening trades. So let's set it up to where it actually closes them. To do that, just simply use strategy.close. Then we're going to give it a few values to tell the bot when we want it to close a position. So we want to reference what position we want to close. So we want to close a long trade when short is true. Then we'll do the opposite for a short. So close out a short position when long is true. So just all this code alone, in theory, will buy every time when the 50-day crosses below the 20-day and will sell when the 50-day crosses above the 20-day. It'll also do the opposite with short trades. trades. Let's run it to see if it works. To do that, go to the tab up here, add to chart, and that will start our backtest. So it looks like it worked. The cool thing about TradingView is that it'll actually display on the chart where it bought and sold. This way you can check to see if the bot is running correctly and buying and selling where you actually want it to. You also have these three different tabs. The overview tab will show you an equity curve, your net profit, amount of trades, max drawdown, average trade, etc. So this is the tab you want to be looking at to see how successful your strategy actually is. And it looks like this strategy wasn't that bad. The performance summary basically gives the same information, but in a table format. Then there's the list of trades tab where it'll show you every single trade and when and how it was executed. So you can see here we went back to 2020. So maybe you don't want to test all the way back to 2020. Well, you actually can edit the script to where you can tell the bot a specific amount of time you want to test. To do that, just go to the line right here and create a start and end variable. Then we're going to use the pre-built timestamp function. So we're going to set our start to, let's say, 2021, January 1st, and then hours, then minutes. Then we'll make our endpoint, let's say, 2021, August 1st. So this is saying it'll only do trades from January to August on only the S&P 500. Then we have to make an if statement. So if time is greater than or equal to our start variable, and if time is less than or equal to our end variable, we will run this code below. Then you just indent this. Then go to the add to chart button and boom, it only did trades from January to August. I should also mention that when you're getting this error below, when you click add to chart, just go to the first line of your code and type in /@version=4. That'll get rid of the error. Now, maybe you want to see your actual indicators from the bot on the chart. Well, there's actually a way to do that too. There's a pre-built function called the plot function. So you just do plot, parentheses, then whatever indicator you want, the name, the color, then the width. Then boom, it shows you the moving averages on the chart, which is pretty cool. But maybe you want it actually overlaid on the chart as you normally would have it when you add these indicators. To do that, just go here and set overlay to true. Then bada bing, bada boom, you have the indicator overlaid on the chart. Like I said, guys, this is a very basic strategy and example, but I just wanted to show you the very basic opportunities you have with backtesting. If you want to see a tutorial that's more advanced and how to backtest some more advanced strategies, let me know in the comments and give this video some love and like the video. And if it gets enough love, I'll make a second tutorial, because there's some pretty crazy things you can do with TradingView backtesting. Now that you know how to backtest, you should try backtesting one of my strategies like this one, where I show you one of my secret strategies that has a pretty high success rate. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.